Morning students, last class we had to discuss about the electrolysis lawsuit. Before you are going to Faraday's law means one time, once I am repeat that exception case. What is exception case means? In aqueous Li plus comma, Na plus comma, K plus comma, cesium plus ions present in aqueous means in place of this one in cathode, what gas liberated? Hydrogen gas is liberated. Because of the hydrogen reduction potential is greater than that of the these type of first A group cations present in the aqueous means in that place hydrogen gas liberated at cathode, that is. Okay, now in same thing in aqueous ions like SO4 minus 2, NO3 minus or carbonate ion or chloride ions present in the aqueous means in place of this one the anode, what gas liberated means oxygen gas is liberated. Okay, now suppose for example aqueous K2SO4 using the platinum electrode, what is the gases are liberated at the cathode and anode? Answer is, in place of K plus ion is there, in place of aqueous means K plus place, what is the gas is liberated? Hydrogen gas liberated at cathode. Okay, now in place of sulfate, what gas liberated? Oxygen gas liberated at anode. Using the inert electrodes like platinum electrode, that is the reason. Now in these two is very important. So here the aqueous is very important, but not in a fused. Fused there means there are originally follows, but only in the aqueous is there means this is the rule. So I am writing means cathode and anode. Cathode means generally positive ions, anode means negative ion, anode means oxidation, cathode means reduction. So this is the two exception case, that is. Last class you have to take with the some important concept is there, that is what is called Q is equal to quantity of electric current is equal to I into T, and the formula is there. Q is equal to I into T, where I is equal to what is there? Current in an ampere, where T is equal to time in a seconds. Okay, na? That's why Q is equal to I into T. But before, suppose N moles of electricity positive means what is the formula? NF. Where F is equal to 1 Faraday. Therefore, the charge of 1 mole of electron is called, what is the name? Faraday. Faraday means charge of 1 mole of electron. 1.02 × 10⁻¹⁹ coulomb into 6.02 × 10⁻²³, that is equal to 96,488 or 96,500. Okay, na? But N mole of electron means N Faraday. Suppose for example aluminum plus 3 electron utilized to aluminum. Here how many number of Faradays of current will be passed means here number of electrons required means 3 electron. Therefore the answer is equal to 3 Faraday. 3 Faraday means 3 × 96,500 coulombs. Okay, na? For example, Na plus is there 1F, Mg plus 2 is there 2F, air plus 3 is there, 3 up, depending upon the number of electrons, so that is equal to the, so formula NF, that is. Okay, now last class you have to, so Q is equal to I into T. But number of electrons possible means how many number of atoms means NF. NF means N means number of electrons. Faraday means F from Faraday is equal to 96,500. The charge of one mole of electrons is called Faraday. Now today, based on that one, there are two important laws are there. What are the losses? Now today we have discussed with the first law, Faraday's first law. What is the first law? Faraday's first law. If Faraday's law depends with the quantity of electricity and mass of the substance is relation is known as Faraday's law. Now what is meant by Faraday's law means, what is the condition? The relation between the mass of the substance liberated or dissolved at an electrode during the electrolysis, it depends with the quantity of electricity is called as a Faraday's law. But Faraday's first law means what is called? The amount of substance liberated or dissolved. The amount of substance liberated or dissolved at an electrode on electrolysis. On electrolysis. Before I am telling you, electrolysis means electrolyte will be electrolysis. Electrolyte means nothing but the electrode. Every electrolyte immersed in what is there? Electrodes. The electrodes are immersed into the electrolyte. After that, by passage of electric current, the electrolysis will be completed. Okay, now that's why the amount of substance liberated or dissolved at an electrode during the electrolysis is directly proportional to what is called directly proportional to the quantity of electricity. What is that? Quantity of electricity is called Faraday's first law. Before, what I am telling you, the relation between the mass of the substance and the quantity of electricity is called as a Faraday's law. In that Faraday's first law, the amount of substance liberated or dissolved at an electrode during the electrolysis the directly proportional to the quantity of electricity is called Faraday's first law. Okay, na? Now, what is the formula? Mass of the substance means M, directly proportional to Q, where Q is equal to quantity of electricity, where M is equal to mass of the substance liberated or dissolved at an electrode during the electrolysis, is directly proportional to the quantity of electricity, is called Faraday's first law. It is a very, 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 very most important for PUC exam. So in that object, the problems is very important based on the Faraday's first and the second laws. There are two laws in there. Now we are today discussing the first law. The first law is briefly what I am told. The mass of the substance directly proportional to the quantity of electricity. So passed into the electrode during the electrolysis is called as a Faraday's first law. So now M directly proportional to Q. Therefore, M is equal to Z into Q. Where Z is equal to what is called proportionality coefficient. What are very important is electrochemical equivalent. What is called Z? Electrochemical equivalent or proportionality constant. Okay, na? M is mass of substance, Q is equal to quantity of electricity, M is equal to ZQ, Z is equal to proportionality constant, or other name is called Z is equal to electrochemical equivalent. Small e, C, E. Electrochemical equivalent. That is called Z. Okay, now very, very important Z. So here Z2. Next, M is equal Z into, why the formula for before Q is equal to I into T. Therefore, Z into I into T. Okay, now M is equal to Z into I. Where I is equal to current in ampere, T is equal to time in seconds only. So Z is equal to electrochemical equivalent or proportionality constant. M is equal to mass of the substance. So therefore, the mass of the substance directly proportional to the quantity of electricity passed in electrode during the electrolysis is called Faraday's first law. Therefore, M is equal to other formula Z into ID. Now here, very important, what is the Z? Z means electrochemical equivalent. So Z is equal to what is other formula? E by F. What is that? E by F. But what is meant by E by F? E means equivalent weight divided by Faraday. What is called? Faraday. Okay, other name is called chemical equivalent or equivalent weight divided by Faraday. That is equal to Z. Z means electrochemical equivalent. What is the definition? The ratio between the equivalent weight or chemical equivalent and Faraday is called Z. Z is equal to E by F. Okay, na? Now suppose E. E by F means Faraday. Faraday means how much coulombs? 96,500 coulombs. But what is the units of Z? Equivalent weight means what is called? Weight and equivalence coulomb inverse. What is called? Equivalent weight into coulombs means 96,500. Therefore, coulomb upside means coulomb inverse. Okay, na? So other name is called grams coulomb inverse. Another name is called equivalent weight means grams. Grams divided by coulombs. That is equal to Z. Okay, na? So therefore, here E means equivalent weight or chemical equivalents. Z is equal to electrochemical equivalent. F means Faraday. Now very, very important is what is meant by electrochemical equivalent. The ratio between the equivalent weight and the Faraday is called electrochemical equivalent. That units are grams per coulomb or grams coulomb inverse. Where Z is equal to electrochemical equivalent, that is equal to ECE. ECE means small z, or other name is called proportionality constant. So therefore, Z is equal to E by F. One F is equal to 96,500 coulomb. The units of electrochemical equivalents are grams per coulomb or grams coulomb inverse. Where M is equal to mass of the substance, where I is equal to current in ampere, where T is equal to time in seconds, therefore formula M is equal to Z into I into T. Next, M is equal to Z plus what is the formula? E into IT divided by Faraday. What is the formula? E into I into T divided by F. There was a formula Z. Z plus what is the formula? E by F. This is equal to E by F into ID. So that is equal to mass. Okay, na? Now we are first we will see in a basic concept means what is the formula for equivalent weight? What is the formula? M is equal atomic weight divided by valency into I into T divided by F. This is the other formula. Now in place of E, what I am writing? Atomic weight divided by valency. Atomic weight divided by valency. Suppose, what is the equivalent weight of Cu plus 2 means 63.5 divided by 2. Okay, na? What is the equivalent weight of aluminum plus 3? 27 divided by 3, that is equal to 9. Okay, na? Equivalent weight of Mg plus 2 means 24 divided by 2. Equivalent weight of Na plus is equal to 23 by 1. Therefore, here what is the formula for a capital E means? When a capital E is equal to, so chemical equivalent or equivalent weight. What is the formula for equivalent weight? Atomic weight divided by valency. So 1 Faraday is equal to how much coulombs? 96,500 coulombs. Therefore, M is equal atomic weight I T divided by valency into 96,500 coulombs. This is the formula for Faraday's first law. The Faraday's first law is related to the mass of the substance with the quantity of electricity, nothing but the Faraday's law. And the Faraday's first law means the mass of the substance so dissolved or liberated at an electrode during the electrolysis is directly proportional to the quantity of electricity is called Faraday's first law. M directly proportional to Q. M is equal to Z Q, where Z is equal to electrochemical equivalent. Z is equal to E by F formula. Capital E means equivalent weight. F means Faraday. The ratio between the equivalent weight and Faraday is called electrochemical equivalent. The units of electrochemical equivalent is equal to grams per coulomb. So okay na? That's why M is equal to Z into IT. Z plus what is right? E by F into IT. What is the formula for equivalent weight or chemical equivalence? Atomic weight divided by valency into F. Therefore, the total formula M is equal atomic weight into current in ampere into time in seconds divided by 96,500 into valency. That is the formula for Faraday's first law. Okay, na? So Faraday's first law. Suppose an object to direct mass not given. What is the formula of mass for? Density equal to mass by volume. So mass is equal to density into volume. Therefore, density into volume is equal. So what is the formula? Atomic weight I T divided by what is the next? Valency into 96,500 coulombs. Okay, na? So therefore, what you can observe this Faraday's law means the mass of the substance directly proportional to the quantity of electricity. So the quantity of electricity means Q. Q formula last class IT. So Z IT. Z means proportionality constant. Here very very important is Z. Z is nothing but again I am telling you what is meant by Z means electrochemical equivalent or proportionality constant. Proportionality constant. Z is equal to E by F. Grams per coulomb. So where E is equal to chemical equivalent or so equivalent weight. What is the formula for equivalent weight? Atomic weight divided by valency. I am telling you two different examples. Okay, na? That's why this is called as Faraday's first law. Based on this one, we have to do the problems for different. So, here what are the parameters? What you can calculate? Current in here, amperes calculate, time calculate, mass of the substance calculate, atomic weight calculate, valency calculate, but only constant is 96,500 coulombs. 1 farad is equal to 96,000 farad. Only that is a constant. Remaining all parameters you have calculated using this formula. What is the formula? M is equal to atomic weight into current in ampere into time in seconds divided by valency into 96,500. That is equal to mass of the substance equal. Therefore, this is called as a Faraday's first law. Next, you have to discuss with the Faraday's second law in next class. Thank you.